excellent work done. There, when I came to campus today, I actually walked around. A lot of things have changed in the last 10 years, I can tell you, definitely. All for the good. Something from your presentation, and one thing that probably you should learn is that probably most of you in the final years, or are you all first year?
Final
year. It's a mixed group. So those of you who are in the first year, those who are in the final year going out, whenever you go for an event, this is an event, but even if you go, if you work in an industry, in an organization, and you get a case study, won't get case studies like this. Your boss will tell you, go and find this out. He will give you one line at max. Try and develop it on your own. Don't go by what's fixed here. One of the, I won't name any team to say any, one of the people who did, they broke it down. This case study has a lot of things which you can interpret on your own. Whether presenting to somebody who's judging you here for points, or whether you're presenting to anybody when you're judging in an industry where you're trying to either sell business for your own company or sell a strategic idea within your company to your boss or to his boss or to someone who's coming to have a collaboration with your company, it's always good to present first what you thought about. Give the idea that this is what we were given, this is what the assumptions we made. So that the person is very sure that if you've made, not made a certain assumption, he can ask you about it. If that is not clear, what happens, it leaves ambiguity to everyone. They're not able to decide whether you thought about something or not. Today you have 5 minutes to discuss when you're on a corporate world and you're presenting. It's the first 15 minutes and after that, it's all downhill. I can tell you that. If you can catch your person for the first 15 minutes, you've made a killing. That's all you need, 15 minutes, and then that conversation can go on for 6 hours, or after 15 it can end in the next 20 as well. Always good to present it. Be clear on what you want to do. This case study, if I would have looked at it, I would have said, who do I want to target? The first line says, Bajaj wants to, and it's over here, says, they want to sell it to the auto rickshaw wallahs. Very clearly, it says there. For me, if I get better public transport, I will use it. I will not be an influencing factor for someone in a trade union or someone who's an auto rickshaw driver to go and buy an RE60 or an Arjun or whatever you want to call it. I will not be the influencing factor. For me, I need better public transport. But I'll tell you, you know, I will go in a public transport only if you drive a close four-way to a level. He says, I don't care for you. I've got many more who sit in mine. So the target audience for all of you should have ideally been the person who is going to drive it. One demographic came out, 65% of the people own it on their own. I might be wrong, but quite a few of you said bulk discount for buying bulk autos. 65% is not going to buy bulk autos. Trade unions might. How much of an influencing factor will they have? Will a trade union want to invest to buy so many autos and give it ahead? They might get 60 people to come together and buy it. Will that discount be passed on to the person below or no? Or you're giving it to the person in the middle? As good corporate governance, every company today does not want to have middlemen. They want to have someone as an agent there to whom they can give a certain requisite amount. You don't want to give him 30%. You might not want to give him 1%. But you want to give him a certain requisite amount which is good enough for what he has done for you. Not just because you have to put in money into someone's pocket to sell your product. And I'm coming from the corporate governance point of view, right? You want to make India a better country. If you guys don't start thinking about it today, you're not going to be able to implement it when you go out there. You might not be able to implement it in the first go. Keep trying. It's not a sermon, but sincerely telling you, I've seen it, and I've seen a lot of other people who are much senior to me. They actually come back and say, we like it if someone makes an effort to follow this. We'd like it not to be done. It's in today's newspapers. I just read Bharti Walmart has fired 5 of their CFOs, right? Even from their legal team, people who are supposed to be present there so that they don't do these practices. Foreign Corrupt Practices Act in the US is very big. Companies pay billions of dollars just to stay away from it. The company I work for, we have cases, thankfully not in FRCPA, But people have sued us for millions of dollars. We've thankfully not been liable in any of them. We provide technology. We provide assurance to the customer. That's how it works. Always think about that in anything, any presentation that you make. Don't go by the idea that you have to give the big global picture. It is important, but also look at the feasibility of its application. It becomes very important. And the feasibility in a country like ours has to be taken from the fact that we still need a lot of civil, you can't say obedience, but you need to have this ability to follow what the law says. Right? We did civil disobedience to get our independence. Unfortunately, that civil disobedience after independence is not very helpful. It still continues. But at that point of time, it was different. You did it for a certain reason. But today, be good civilians. I mean, it's your own country. You have to help it. The more you help it, I'm telling you, the better. Well, you might not need an RE60. You might have a BMW or a Merc come in and tell you, I'll give you a vehicle at this price and I will give it to your public department for free. Get the people to drive it. If you go to Singapore, they have such great systems over there. But even that country suffers. At peak hour, you cannot get a taxi in Singapore. Cannot. They charge you a premium. You hail down a cab, it's $1.60. You call in a cab, it's $3.20. At peak hour, it's $5 to just call in a cab. Where in India do we charge that? We don't. It's not that we should charge. People are willing to pay for it. I know when Meru cab started, now if you call in, it's 50 rupees. You go online, it's free. They're charging you for what? Because they're running a call center. Feasibility to run it. Cards, you can give cards, but the feasibility to run a back end is there. So whenever making presentations, it should be as realistic and as applicable and as feasible as it should be. Think out of the box, but once you've done that, try and put it into practical application to the best of your knowledge. And that's when it really becomes effective, not only to you as a learning process, but even to somebody who's coming to judge you. And it's not that I have seen much. I probably have seen a few more years of corporate life than you have. So I have seen much more than I have on the education side. And the corporate was, you teach them, you work with them very closely. It's our experiences that can, you know, we give. And this is one of the best things that, and I actually learned this at IMT. Probably my early institutions as well. I used to be part of this committee here, which unfortunately doesn't exist any longer. It used to be called the Business Contact Committee. So I used to be part of that. The idea for us was to go and meet with the corporates and to then come back and relate what the corporates really want from us back to the people. That interaction becomes very important. As long as you're able to relate to them, understand what they really want, it's a different ballgame. I have seen people go up the ladder who have been mediocre at work within an organization. People think they're not the best, but they have done far better for themselves than someone who can come and talk cab like this. Not saying that I haven't done decently well, I've done decently well for myself. But the gift of the gab is important, but not as important as your own ethical values and how you put yourself into application in the industry. And I said to one of them, I have probably, when I joined my first job, you might have worked at a grocery, but I joined at 6,500 rupees a month, stipend. Six and a half thousand rupees a month. That's it. That's what I was paid for my first job. I worked 9 to 6. It's not that I had lesser hours. I still had to report to someone and I worked at that salary for a year. I don't think anybody in this room wants to work at 6,500 rupees a month. That's probably what some of you spend over a weekend. Right? So, India has grown. Today, that was my salary out of my engineering, right out of engineering. Today, right out of engineering, probably you get much, much higher salaries. Some of them get salaries even what we owned after our MBAs get, right? So, but there's nothing to feel bad about it. It's how the industry is. Things are different. Every industry is different. Every sector is different. So be sure of what you go out and do in the morning. Marketing is great fun. I've done it. I've done most of my time, I've done B2B marketing. So it's great fun. I have not done B2C marketing. So if you tell me to go and sell something to a customer, I might still be able to do it. Because remember, it's a skill set that you make for yourself. The skill set that you make for yourself, you can apply it anywhere as long as you use your brains. That's all I wanted to say, and I had a great time coming back to campus, some excellent presentations. And if any of you felt that we asked you questions which we asked the other team, but in a different manner, that's because that's how judging is done. So you might have said the same point, and you might not have got questioned, but somebody else got questioned on it. So that's how judging is done, because the idea is not to beat you down, the idea is to think what you've been thinking at the background. A lot of time you can't put things on paper, you can't put them up here. There's a lot of thought that goes behind it. I've made presentations, so I've probably made presentation, and I'll tell you, I made a presentation in this campus on the operational management of Coke and how it delivers. My presentation did not have more than 2 lines in it. It had only pictures, and I presented for 45 minutes. Well, for a marketing class, M2, I presented in this, not in Chanakya, one of the rooms. I presented 45 minutes, 10 slides, 2 lines, which are the opening line says, Coke present this by team number, and it had 8 people's name on it. That's it. That was my first slide, and after that, the last slide said, thank you. It's marketing. If you're able to sell what you put up on pictures over there by what you're delivering, it makes a much bigger point. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a good career there. Thank you.
Do not have better words, and I would let you absorb and assimilate what you listened to just now. I would only say one thing. I'm really happy. First, the number of presentations was kept to 7, and number 2, since the bar was raised high, the quality of presentation is really good. And I'm really happy that you're actually looking into a real life situation, and people actually moved on to field and talk to the segment whom you generally do not talk to. You simply view the person from the back side as somebody else presented over here. Right? Great learning for you. Good learning for us as well. Thank you.